The objective of this tutorial is to browse a list of customers in a customer package's web page, and to navigate into other web applications in order to obtain additional information. Whatever the value read in the customer package page, the information will be displayed. But the eligibility status will differ. If the eligibility status is no, and the details button is clicked, a new application is launched. It is then necessary to fill the first two information to obtain the last one, after having validated. If the eligibility status is yes, and the details button is clicked, a new page of the same application is displayed. All the information is available. We're starting a new project again. Let's accelerate its creation, this being now quite simple to realize. For this first phase of the declaration of objects, we will also accelerate certain actions. Application and page recognition criteria are simply taken from these examples on titles. A table in the web page is processed here by the span tag and extended to the whole table by the occurs option. For the second application, two pages are to be considered. Particular attention is paid to the recognition criteria of the Terminal Info's application. Indeed, we chose to take a criterion related to the title of the window. However, on the two pages declared, when the second page is displayed, the title changes. The consequence is simple: the criterion for the application is to be modified. We can simply modify this criterion by not considering the entire title, but just the common part between the two pages. Don't forget to click on the Update button. The third application is also simple to declare. Generally speaking, do not forget to put yourself in the production conditions, so that all the fields that will be handled during the orchestration phase appear as soon as the declaration is made. Okay. The object declaration phase is complete. In order to be sure that everything is well recognized, it is suggested to launch a compilation, then a launch of the process. Everything is nominal, without error. Running in debugger mode shows that the three applications are already launched and well recognized. As already shown in a previous video, you can also use the tools available in the debugger to read data in the pages, enter new values on the fly and click on the buttons that have been declared. One small save and we move on to the second phase, orchestration. First of all, a little trick, interesting in some cases. By default, in the workflow designer, each time a GET activity is requested, then a variable is automatically created in the context. We can remove this option in order to master context management as part of our exercise. We can now create the workflow. By first launching the main application. Since it is mainly a question of looping the different lines, let us insert the corresponding activity. Since all the lines must be read, the loop exit, which we positioned just before the actual reading, will be done as soon as the client ID field is no longer valued, that is to say, will no longer exist. This client ID field is the central point of this automation. We will declare it manually, through a mini structure to build in context. We can use the get activity to evaluate it in the properties field. A small backup and we continue by launching the terminal info page. Attention! This is the activity of launching a page and not an application. Indeed. This application has two pages. By adding the desired page in the design area and double-clicking on it, you enter the detail of this page. It is simply a matter of playing with the mouse. First by searching the client ID field in the context, and clicking the search button. It is then a question of recovering the four fields of the window, by making them slide towards the context. Hence the advantage of having suspended the automatic creation of fields, they would each have been created in their application. With this way of doing things, it is easier to have a coherent context and provide output data, whatever the source. The details button is the key to getting the second page of the application, or disconnecting it to the third application. Assuming in the future that this application only displays the details button under certain conditions, we can train. In case, we position an existing wait activity on the button, with a click in case of presence. Now back to the two cases considered, new page or new application. It is necessary to position a multiple choice activity. By default, or not, just modify the label. Let's position the second page of the same application. This is the case where eligibility is positive. It is only necessary to save the fields in context with the get activity. Quickly. The following case is to be named. Here it concerns partners, for example. By filling in the ID, serial number and validation, the request ID can be saved back. We also take this opportunity to close the partner's application. It will be reopened if necessary. After this conditional treatment, we can insert a so-called specific activity, which is not processed by the workflow designer. This can correspond to a JavaScript processing a posteriori, just to structure the process. It is now enough to complete the loop that was initialized at the beginning. Possibly add a specific activity again. Then close the two applications used, the third one is closed during the process. A new backup of the process is required. And above all, since we are going to do a loop on the web array and store everything in memory in the context, it is necessary to specify that the storage will be in the form of an array of fields. We can compile the project and launch the robot, always with the debugger, to follow the execution. The robot reads the table and executes the instructions without any problem, alternating application activations or pages. There you go. It's all over. Note that in the next tutorial, we will continue this one, by adding the possibility of saving the data stored in memory on an external support, Excel sheet, Word table, or file in format, CSV, XML, JSON for example. Good practice.